The third elephant in the room is climate change.
The one thing we can be absolutely certain of is that climate is going to be much more unstable. Now, why is that important to sustainability? Well, in my view, the reason it's important to sustainability, because again, if you think about our current agricultural systems, and again, I don't care whether it's conventional or organic, but our current agricultural systems tend to be highly monoculture, highly specialized, and whenever you have specialized monocultures, you absolutely have to have stable climates that are favorable to that particular monoculture. In Iowa now, 92% of our cultivated land is in just two crops, corn and soybeans. That means we need to consistently have climate that's favorable to corn and soybeans if we're going to maintain productivity. We're not likely to have that. And all you have to do, and Cynthia Rosenzweig says quite bluntly that for farmers, climate change is here already. And all you have to do is read the newspapers these days to know that that's in fact true. Look at what's happening in Australia, what's happening in China, what's happening in Argentina, what's happening in Texas, what's happening in California. You probably saw the article the other day that the federal government is now considering cutting off irrigation water for farmers in California in March because in order to have sufficient water available for firefighters, et cetera. Now, whether or not that in fact happens depends on whether or not, you know, we get some more rain in California in the next couple of weeks. But think about what that means for farmers in California, which are enormously dependent on irrigation water. And what it therefore means to all of you who are in the food business who may be depending on your food products from California. So we have to take climate change into consideration. The fourth element in the room is our ecological degradation. Now, at the same time that we're facing this new future, we have degraded our ecological resources, which are the foundation of any kind of agricultural system. The UN, the UN Millennium Ecosystem Assessment Report indicated that agriculture over the last 60 years has been the primary contributor to the destruction of biodiversity. Now again, we have quite logically, with our thinking about steady state sustainability, we quite logically have thought about our food systems in terms of specializing to make things more efficient, to reduce our labor requirements, et cetera. And in an interest of doing that, we created these highly specialized systems. But in the process of doing that, we destroyed so much of the biodiversity that used to be a part of our ecological landscapes, including, most fundamentally, we have destroyed the diversity of our soils. Our soils now are no longer biologically active organisms. We have considered them over the last 60 years or so simply as dirt to hold a plant in place while we provide all of the nutrients, et cetera, that the plants need. And so we now have soil that no longer absorbs and holds water the way it once did. It's one of the reasons that we need, here's where we start to see the interrelationships of all of these four issues. The soil no longer absorbs and retains as much moisture as it once did when it was biologically active. It no longer has the nutrient capacity and the self-renewing capacity. And so in my view, one of the major systems changes that we need to make globally is to have a global program now to restore the biological health of our soils. And if we're going to do that, we have to have more biodiversity in our agriculture in order to do it. That's where the redesign of the system begins to come in. You can't restore the biological health of the soil and here's where organic can make a great contribution, because in the history of the organic movement, there is a lot of information which we now need and which we can use to create these new systems. And so you go back to people like Sir Albert Howard and Lady Eve Balfour, et cetera, it was all there. What we need to do and how we need to do it. In fact, Sir Albert Howard at one point called the NPK mentality, which was the new agriculture was just emerging, as a form of banditry. Because he knew already back then that we were going to be destroying the biological health of the soil and future generations were going to need that. So the really important thing for us to do as an organic community is to go, and I'm not saying going back to the way things were in the late 1800s, early 1900s. I'm saying going back to capture some of that wisdom and then marry it with the best science we have available today as we redesign systems as we move toward this new future.